All right, our goal on this is to find side length C if we know that A is 2.92 miles and B is going to be 3.19 miles, and then we have an angle C is going to be 40.6 degrees. So I've gone ahead and drawn a triangle, kind of labeled everything. You always make sure that C is opposite of C, right? So angle C is opposite of side length C. Same things with A's and B's. All right, so in this case, we don't have an opposite pair, like both the A's or both the B's, both the C's. So we can't use law of sines, and we definitely don't know that this is going to be a right triangle, so we're kind of limited to law of cosines. Now, in setting this up, I realized that our formula over here, we don't have like capital C, but that would be represented right here. So I'm going to use this bottom version to help us set this up and go ahead and solve down for little c. So in setting this up, I'm going to say C squared is equal to A, 2.92 squared, plus B, 3.19 squared, minus 2 times A, 2.29, times B, 3.19, times cosine of the 40.6 degrees. So when you're doing this problem, because it's in degrees, make sure your calculator is in degree mode. Most of this is just going to be a calculator problem. The only thing we still need to do, though, is isolate C and get rid of that square. So to get rid of that, I'm going to apply a square root to both sides. So in punching this in, that'll get C on one side by itself. I'm going to use the square root key, and then it'll start a set of parentheses. I'm going to have to be careful and close that set of parentheses at the very, very, very end. So I'm punching this in, 2.92 squared plus 3.19 squared minus 2 multiplied by each one of these cosine button, making sure we're in degree mode, 40.6, close the set of parentheses off for the cosine, and then close off the square root at the very, very end. All right, after we press enter, I'm going to get 2.13484, and this keeps going on. Keep as many decimal places as you need. That's going to be in miles because each one of these other side lengths was also in miles. All right, hope this helps out in setting up and plugging into the law of cosines. Not a ton of great information that you can glean from this. All you can see is that I just plugged in for each one of these as we went through. And then basically it was calculator. All right, so good luck as you're working through it. See you.